Welcome back to Movie Recap. Today I'm gonna show you a 2015 American action war film called, War Pigs. Spoilers ahead. Sit back, relax, and enjoy the video. The movie starts with a soldier handing his office order from a battalion that he confirmed twice. A few moments later, another battle is occurring. The sergeant and the lieutenant are now in charge, but plenty of bullets are smashing the air. The sergeant says to his lieutenant that their place is great for an ambush. Now, bombs are flying through, and chaos started again as if it's a normal thing. They stay low and keep on going, because they need to find the flank. The lieutenant decides to go beyond the enemy, and shoot them one by one, leaving the sergeant to stay low. They are talking now as they meet, but a bullet strike through the sergeant. The lieutenant comes in rage as he shoots the one at fault for the sergeant's death. Afterward, the colonel meets the lieutenant praising him because he follows orders. He then, decides to give him new orders and jobs in terms of leading men. A new captain introduces him as he will join the lieutenant in the fight. The men that they will train are named, War Pigs. Formerly, men are playing outside, and stealing eggs that they are now eating for breakfast. They are doing cards, and talking about their achievements. While eating on a table, a soldier breaks their laugh saying that they have a new officer coming in. The lieutenant and sergeant continue their way towards the War Pigs area. Tension arises as they have a conversation because these men cannot take orders and guidelines thoroughly, especially the team leader. After a few talks, they will now enter the United States Army as they train for the first time. The War Pigs need to get up at 5 a.m., but they are still asleep, so the lieutenant wakes them up with banging metallic things. The sergeant of the team is the one who comes prepared last, thus leading to disappointment to the lieutenant. Moreover, still, tension surrounds the two of them as they open up the conversation wherein the lieutenant made his men killed. The soldiers are now marching for 3 miles double line as training for being the best squad in the whole US Army. Even though they are about and throwing up, they continue hiking. As they reach the end of the line, the captain attempts to give them a surprise, a huge mountain of sand sacks. The soldiers, confusingly asking about the huge pile of weightful sacks, the captain makes them carry those while hiking. After the tiring training for the soldiers, they are now learning about communication during the war. Still, the team sergeant is making the officers a laughingstock, and disrespecting them. They hike through the mountains again, carrying a big and heavy sack. Back to the lecturing, they need to have drawing skills to describe and record what they observe on a battlefield. They make a bowl of fruits to be in the center for the soldiers to draw them in 2 minutes. However, the War Pigs, especially their team leader, seem to find it drawing, and cannot see the purpose as to why they needed to draw. The lieutenant asks for Plan B. A beautiful lady comes through, removes her clothes, and lets the men draw her. A few lines and curves later, they are out again on the mountains to search for landmines as part of their training. Their next training is, again, carrying a heavy sack at the top of their head while hiking. The next one is learning about a gun, the German K-98. They are learning its parts, and the whole process of assembling it, even blindfolded. Finally, the training ends as the sun bids goodbye for the day. At the officers' camp, the captain notices swinging medals from the lieutenant's pants. He says that it is from the sergeant he served with. The captain says that, maybe, the lieutenant is keeping those to not remind him of his failures as he said so, but instead he cannot get away from his past. The soldiers are now outside in the night with fire as their light as they converse regarding the lieutenant as they are starting to like him. He then, the lieutenant, appears, sharing them a hot coffee. The next morning, training greets them as they wake up. Their first lesson is rope climbing. It started nice, but then, a few climbs later, they decided to drop mild dynamites through the river to make them climb through the rope faster. Their next training is the art of the knife, wherein they learn to defend themselves with the pointy tool. Preacher, because he insults the captain calling him a frog, is the first in line to do the training. He cannot defend himself while battling with the captain. On the other hand, the lieutenant and team sergeant book down a knife fight. August keeps on ranting about how the lieutenant will get them all killed while losing the game. Later on, the captain and the lieutenant give them a badge that has a skull and black as its background. It is their new insignia. The officers are announcing that they are going behind enemy lines, giving them a hint that they are already prepared to go on a battle. The War Pigs team leader or sergeant assures them that he got them all in his back. They will come back healthy and alive. The captain and the lieutenant are now back again on their camp, taking as they will see the colonel the next day. They are also talking about how they miss their home as well as their families. They are now in France, Alsace-Lorraine region to meet the colonel. At his office, he presents plenty of pictures. In the image, it composes a big built gun or cannon that can kill a lot of people. Colonel says that Hitler can be building that kind of thing. He wants them, the captain and the lieutenant, to go and see if it is true. Later on, that day, the two leaders come into the war pigs camp. They reported Hitler's plan onto building himself a new superweapon, a millipede gun, a pressurized cannon that can fire artillery over 100 miles. The soldiers ask where it is exactly, and they receive the answer that it is on Alsace-Lorraine. With quite a shock, the soldiers say it is ways behind the enemy's line and territory. The lieutenant assures them that the war pigs are ready and they can do it. The captain tells them to decide who to drive, and they are good to go. Moffat is now driving together with the lieutenant, and he mindlessly say his wife wants to go to Germany funnily. Lieutenant Jack then comforts him that he will see her again. They now pass the enemy boundary. Nervously, they all take cover for themselves as a handful of aircraft is soaring through the sky. They are in plain sight towards the enemy, so they stop for a while, looking on flying planes, and wondering if they are going to be shot because they are on the wrong side of the line. They all decide to be on their foot since the aircraft are taking too long on the watch. The war pigs team leader asks the sergeant where they are exactly. The lieutenant answers that the gun should be over the ridge, hill 314, west of where they are located. They are needing 2 volunteers for the scouting patrol. The war pigs sergeant and his 1 soldier are on the go. The officer captain needs someone to go on the road. Preacher, one of the soldiers, agrees to go on site. He needs to go on the bend of the road, find a low position, look for movement, and if he sees anything, he needs to hurriedly come back to their original location and report. On the other hand, the lieutenant together with 2 soldiers are walking across the road when they see a big cannon formed lowly above their location. They are assuming it to be 600 feet above, sure is a big thing as they describe it as ugly, but it looks like it can be operational. The lieutenant says their work is done, and they now need to get out of where they are. Confusingly, the sergeant asks if that is it, but it is the only thing they need to report, and there they go ahead. Within the location under the captain, Moffat is digging in mining holes, and is indeed doing good work. Preacher, in a hurry, runs through them saying that German armors are coming down the road. They need to take cover or else the enemy will see them. Quietly, they are now hiding against the enemies that are now just on their front side. The Germans are confidently walking while the soldiers are in instant panic mode. The German throws a grenade disguised as a bottle, and they shout as the 2 of them get caught. On the other side, the lieutenant that directly gets hit by the thrown grenade rolls over the floor, and suffers from bomb shock. The German is now getting on the armored van as they have the 2 soldiers. With the captain and his soldiers hiding location, 2 big armor vehicles come rolling. They stop on a very location exactly where they are. The captain suspects it as a maintenance check. The soldiers are running out of breath, nervously hiding. A German soldier comes closer to their hiding site as he stops for a whiff of a cigarette. The captain readily prepares his gun as the German soldier sees their truck. He shouts, and the soldiers fire a bullet towards the enemy. There, another battle begins. The war pig soldier throws a grenade at the Germans as they continue giving bullets to each other. The captain confidently goes outside the bushes as he shoots the enemy within the vehicle. Another grenade is thrown towards the enemy, and they seem to lose their number. Plenty of bullets are going through and through. The captain goes through a fight with a German soldier. With the last enemy standing, he shoots it dead. The captain is now looking for more enemies to shoot with when he feels an ache in his stomach. There, he sees and touches blood. A war pig soldier comes his way and asks if he is okay. 2 enemy soldiers are running from their back, and he orders the soldier to get them. He silently screams in pain as his stomach part coats in red. Lying down in the middle of the bush, the lieutenant gets back up from a distressed direct shot of a grenade. He sees 2 German soldiers running their way out, and the 2 soldiers shoot them in no time. As he sees his team, he then reports that their soldiers, August and York, were taken by the German patrol. They then hurriedly come back to the squad. Getting there, they see the captain being treated with his wound. He worriedly asks him if he is okay. He reports to the captain that they saw the millipede gun a few miles from their location, and it is indeed operational. The lieutenant states that they will go in through the German depot and let their soldiers out. A few minutes later, they change into German uniforms as they will go and save the caught soldiers from their team. They now get the German's tank, disguised, ready to face the security. The captain says there is a 50-50 chance of going in there, either they make it out alive or they die, and then, the tank moves its way. On the other hand, August and York, are on a site with their hands tied. The German is now asking them regarding their doings on their territory. He gets curious about their insignia, and York tells him they like to roll on the mat. With a huge amount of rage, the soldier gives him a huge smack in the face. As they are about to save them, the other soldiers are now in the tank moving in the German depot. They are passing through the security and checkpoint very confidently. They arrive smoothly. The lieutenant asks them to stay alert. Back on the site, the 2 soldiers are still hand tied, and York is getting punched directly on the face, leaving him full of bruises. The German asks him what is his drawing that their secret weapon. He tells him to go on the next page where the naked lady sketch is, and again, he gets a big punch. He then punches the sergeant so they are both on the ground with the soldier. York finds a sharp wood, and stabs the German right through his neck. The lieutenant comes to seek for his men, and finds a drawing map of the cannon. He folds it and tucks it in him. A German soldier appears, and he offers his lighter for his cigarette, but he immediately knocks his senses with a big punch. After a few more walks of the lieutenant, he immediately sees his men soldiers, about to be hung. Jack silently grabs his knife in his pants as his defense. York jokes to August that it is a good thing they had those rope training. Hurriedly, the lieutenant cuts the German soldier's neck, and proceeding fights while throwing more punches towards their enemy's men. The men slide while a few of them are running out of breath. Jack is fighting them hard. He twists the neck of the last man standing, as easy as it seems, he knocks them all out. After the intense fight, the lieutenant gets his men out of the hanging yard. He gives to the sergeant his knife to get themselves out. The rest of the soldiers, while waiting, hear that the Germans will go to test fire the millipede gun. The lieutenant gets out together with his men, but a soldier he knocked out, comes quickly towards the camp. He then, follows him, and starts a big fight with bullets. Germans, now alarmed, are now in an unexpected battle with the war pigs and their leaders. They fire their guns endlessly. The soldiers are now throwing grenades towards their enemy. It is a fierce fight. Hastily, the lieutenant comes running and climbing the tank. He then orders the captain to stop the tank and take the shot to the cannon. The captain gives it a big shot, and the millipede gun comes gone in bliss. Going back to their division, the colonel receives the big map of cannon's parts. He says the division is going to be mighty happy about it. He promotes the lieutenant into a higher rank, saying that he and the war pigs are really impressive. He as their commander will be even great. Going back to the camp, the lieutenant promotes his men, stating that they are the best squad in the whole army. The movie ends with them taking cheers shouting, to the war pigs. Thank you for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this to help the channel out. Have a nice day.